I have successfully set up WhatsApp integrations dozens of times. And in this short video, I'll explain you exactly how experts connect WhatsApp with n8n in this short demo.
The first thing we have to do is to create a trigger that activates our workflow. In this case, when we receive a new WhatsApp message. Therefore, we look here for WhatsApp and select WhatsApp Business Cloud. Next, we select the trigger on messages. Then we have to set up our credentials. This is actually the tricky part, since we need a Facebook developer account and a Facebook business account. Both we will cover in this tutorial. By setting up these two accounts, we can obtain a client ID and a client secret. This information we can find on developer.facebook.com. Log in first here. Next thing, we click get started. Now we just fill out the form and follow the instructions. You choose here developer. Once this all is set up, we click create app. Give it a name, n8n automation, for example. And you need to enter a contact email. Use case, you choose others. Click next. As app type, you choose business. And for now, we click create app. Once our Facebook app is created, you should see the following screen. But before we continue, we need first to create our Facebook business account. For that, we head over to business.facebook.com. Your screen might look a little different if you don't have a business account yet. To create one, head over here and click create business portfolio. As business portfolio name, I choose n8n automation and fill out the rest of the form. And click create. Once we have set up our Facebook business account, we go back to our developer account and you should see this screen. If you don't, click add product. Next thing is you click on WhatsApp and click setup. Here we choose our just created business portfolio and click continue. Next thing is we head over to WhatsApp and API setup. Next we have to select a phone number. For simplicity reasons, we just take the test number. And we need to enter a phone number where we can test if this whole setup works. For now, I will just select my own phone number. Next, we click generate access token. For simplicity reasons, I choose here opt-in to our current and future WhatsApp accounts and click continue. After we received our access token, we can finally test our setup by clicking send message. If everything worked fine, you should just now receive the message on your phone. We go to app settings now and click basics. Here we copy the app ID and paste it here for the client ID. Now we copy the app secret, go back to n8n and paste the client secret. Click save. When everything worked, you should see this message. Now we want to make sure that it really works. So I click test app, head over to my phone and type in a random message. And we see it works. We received here a message and the body is, hey, this is a test. After we made sure that our WhatsApp trigger works, we can finally add our first AI agent to process the message and generate an answer. For that, we click here the plus icon and click advanced AI and select this agent and drag and drop to the canvas. Click back to canvas. The first thing we want to do is to connect our WhatsApp trigger with the AI agent. The next thing we have to do is to give this AI agent a chat model. In this case, we just use the OpenAI one. For that to work, you need again to add some credentials. In this case, an API key. But this time it's much easier to obtain than for the WhatsApp. For that, we go to platform.openai.com. If you don't have an account yet, click sign up. Otherwise, log in. Once you signed in, you won't click here settings. Before you get the API key, just make sure that you have some credits on your account. For that, you click to billing and add some credits like $5 or $10. Important, This is not the same as your personal ChatGPT account. Therefore, you need to add extra credits to use the API. Once you added some credits, you head over to API keys and click Create New Secret. Here you give it a name, for example, n8n, and select default project. Click Create Secret. Now we click copy and head back to our n8n workflow and paste here the API key and click Save. When everything worked perfect, then you should see this message. Go back to Canvas. Next, we'll set up the AI agent. Therefore, we double click on it. Select source for prompt defined below. And for this example, we use very simple instructions. You are my assistant. Reply concisely to this message from. Then we drag and drop the name from the sender and the actual message. In this case, hey, this is a test. Let's now test this step to see if the outcome is correct. In this case, the model would answer, "Hi, Eduard. It looks like your test was successful. How can I assist you today?" Sounds good.
Go back to Canvas. The final step is replying via WhatsApp. For that, we add a new note, type in again WhatsApp, choose WhatsApp Business Cloud, and under Actions, we choose Send Message. Drag and drop it here. The following part can be a bit tricky, but don't worry, I clearly guide you through it. We'll need WhatsApp credentials again, but this time they are located differently. We click here, Create Credentials, and now you see we need an access token and a business account ID. If you're new, it might be difficult to find them by yourself. So let's carefully go through it step by step to locate the access token and the business account ID, which are required to send WhatsApp messages. Head back to the Facebook developer dashboard and navigate to WhatsApp API setup. Click Generate Access Token again. Copy this token, that's our access token. And the WhatsApp business account ID is our business account ID that we need here. Click Save. And if everything worked fine, you should see this message.
After we set up our WhatsApp credentials, we just make sure under resource it says message, under operations it says send. Under sender phone number, we just choose our test number. We go back to Canvas, make sure that our AI agent is connected to the sending node. Double click on it again, and now we can choose as the recipient's phone number, the WhatsApp ID, and as the text body, our reply from our AI agent. The last thing we have to do is to click test step and make sure we receive the message. If everything worked fine, you should now receive a message on your phone. That's it. Our workflow works now fine. We can now activate it and it will work live now.
And let me tell you one last important thing. Right now, your WhatsApp sending node secret key will expire every 24 hours, meaning your automation will stop working. To fix that, you are required to generate a new API key every 24 hours. Or you simply create a permanent key. Download my free template below and learn step by step how to create a permanent key in seconds.